Great to see a lot of people already in the chat. Welcome. I'm so glad you guys are here. It's a beautiful sunny day in Southern California. It's a hot one already. It is about 85 degrees out, so we're getting kind of a hot start to our summer. Hello, Dolly. Nice to see you here. I saw Cringe in the chat. And today, it's super exciting. We are doing our second giveaway drawing in the Small Space Garden series. So it was an overwhelming response to the video. So many people love the easy DIY and expensive trellis ideas. If you missed that video, you definitely want to go and check, because you do not have to spend a lot of money with putting up trellises. You can do it for free, you can do it with thrift store items, you can upcycle. So go back and watch the easy DIY trellis video that I posted on Saturday for some really fantastic ideas. But today we are giving away 5 of these 5-gallon Smart Pots containers. So thanks for everyone who left a comment on the video. I think there were over 500 comments, so 500 people entered the giveaway drawing, and we have 5 of these to give away today, along with some surprise bonus prizes. So thanks a lot for joining me, guys. So say hello in the chat and let me know where you're from. I see a lot of people from Chattanooga. Let's see, who else here? From Maryland. That's wonderful. Marianne, hi, how are you? I hope that it's warming up out there. You guys have had a long, hot winter, or long, cold winter. And from Canada, hello, Paul, nice to see you. Anna, hi, great to have you guys on here. Finally, Melissa in Illinois, spring is here. That is amazing. I am so glad it's getting warm out, and I just want to commend you guys. A lot of you are getting your seeds started, getting your gardens planted, and I know it takes a dedication to growing your own food, to being healthier, and I am just so proud of you for the effort and the time that it takes to do that and to bring your families along. I know a lot of you are planting your vegetables with kids and teaching them how to do it along the way. So if it's your first time joining us, we're all about growing your own food in a quick, simple, inexpensive way, being healthier as a result. And I just wanted to read a couple of comments from some of the videos that were particularly inspiring to me. And oh, by the way, before I forget, Everything Sunflowers is in the chat. She's our moderator today. So she's going to be moderating the questions and the comments and just welcoming everyone and making sure everyone has a great time. So a couple of comments that were super inspiring to me this week. Thank you guys so much for taking the time to comment. This first one I'm going to read is from Sophia Parveen. And she is commenting here, I'm so happy I found you on Instagram. I'm happy you found me too, Sophia. I love learning everything about gardening and plants from you. Amazing. You've taught me how I can still have a beautiful garden in my small apartment balcony. So that is so true. You don't have to have a lot of room to grow your own food. You can get just as much joy out of a small garden as you do from a big, huge garden. So Sophia, so true. Thank you so much for sharing that. I'm going to read one more. This one is from Anna Ryan. And Anna has been commenting and watching for quite some time. And she comments, this video was terrific and timely. Last Monday, I visited my doctor, and when my blood test came back, I was diagnosed with pre-diabetes. I've been watching your garden videos and am now taking measures to eat more healthy and stay away from sugar as much as possible. This video has reinforced my plan to take better care of the body God has given me. So yes, it is life-changing when you're growing your own food and eating healthy. You can get rid of, or not get rid of, but help a lot of diseases and really improve your health. So thank you so much for the work you're doing and growing your own food. Great job. And I just heard the gardeners pull up next door, so we might get a little bit of noise. They used to come about 11 or 11:30, and now they're coming about 12, 12:15, right in the middle of our live stream. So sorry, you might have some noise here along the way. So I saw a comment from Jessica, type 1 diabetes here makes a huge difference eating healthy. Absolutely, Jessica. Thank you so much for sharing that. Okay, before we jump into our tips today on vertical gardening and why you should really consider growing vertically, we are going to pick our very first winner. So what we do is I have a program on my computer called the YouTube Random Comment Picker. And I enter the URL of this Saturday's video. Oh, there they go, they're firing up, guys. And it goes through, scrolls through the comments randomly and picks our very first winner. So if your name is picked, what you need to do is email me at calikimgardenandhome.com, or Christy will pop in my email in the comments. My email address is calikim29@calikimgardeninghome.com. And that will also be in the, when this video uploads, in the video description. So without further ado, we are going to choose our first winner. I always forget how to turn the camera around on the video here. Okay, here it is. All right, here you go, guys. Good luck to all, and sorry about the glare here on the screen. Hopefully you can see it. Hopefully you can hear me. Hopefully the gardeners finish up quickly. So it's scrolling through all 495 commenters, unique commenters, and then we're gonna pick a winner. Drum roll, please. You can see the winners right here scrolling by. And our first winner of our 5-gallon Smart Pots fabric container, see if I can get the glare off the screen there for you guys, is Bertha Perales. So Bertha, thank you so much for entering. Congratulations. And her comment says, I learned that I am going to use a lot of my husband's material that is just lying on the property to build my trellis. I'm super excited. I'm growing cucumbers, zucchini, tomatoes, and peppers. Thanks to you, sending blessings. That's awesome. Bertha, congratulations. I am so glad that you're growing your own food and using materials that you just have around the house. So much fun. And Bertha, you also won here a surprise prize. Drum roll, please. What do you guys think it's gonna be? Some guesses in the chat, please. Well, you guys might know or you might not know that I recently opened a seed shop, CALIKIMGardeninghome.com, on my website. Some special seed collection. You got it, Melissa, seeds. And Bertha has won a pack of seeds from my spring garden seed collection, and that is an Arkansas Traveler tomato. So my spring garden seed collection has 12 easy to grow varieties to get you started growing your own food. And we just planted one of these in the garden on the last video in the spring garden series. And this tomato is really special. It's a beautiful, gorgeous tomato. It's also heat tolerant. So if you live in one of those hot climates, this tomato is gonna do very, very, very well for you. So head over to my website, pick up one of my spring garden seed collections, and you can purchase one of these in that kit. So Bertha, congratulations. I'll be sending this to you with your prize. So by the way, one thing I forgot to mention is, I'm so sorry, but the drawing is only open to US residents. I would love to be able to send out the Smart Pots internationally, but international shipping costs are so, so high. So I'm sorry, you guys. I know you really want to be able to do that, but I'm just not able to. So I will be picking a couple of runners up as well. Okay, question in the chat, and then we're gonna head over to our very first tip here. Okay, great, John, good attitude. I feel still like a winner even though I lost. Wonderful. Okay, question. I'm not finding any questions here. I think everyone's just saying congratulations. So maybe we'll head back into the chat in just a moment. But guys, I wanna talk now for a moment about vertical gardening. Vertical gardening can save you so much space. So the first reason to garden vertically, why you should really consider putting up some kind of a trellis and gardening vertically, is you can grow more veggies in smaller amount of space. So look at the trellis right here behind me. This is a cattle panel trellis. And this here is actually a garden shovel that I'm gonna be climbing some cucumbers up. But imagine if I didn't have that trellis there, all this space in here, I would not be able to grow vegetables. So by planting some climbing vegetables, like I've got some cucumbers planted back there, some peas over on the other side, you can grow up instead of out, save yourself a ton of space, and double or triple the amount of vegetables that you can grow. So grow vertically to grow more vegetables. And cattle panels are wonderful. They're super, super sturdy. And I know that Tractor Supply, which is across the country in a lot of locations across the US, has them. We do have a Tractor Supply near us. I haven't checked to see if they carry them. I was able to find one at Lowe's. So just look around, do your research. They're big, long pieces of really heavy duty fencing, and then you can cut it down to fit the size that you want, or you can make an arch like I did in my garden down below. So guys, let's just go into the chat here for a couple of questions. I'm glad you're enjoying the live stream here, and then we're gonna draw one of our other winners. Okay, here's a great question. I actually wanted to cover this today. Philippe, do cucumbers or zucchini need any shade, or should they get a full 6 to 8 hours of full sun? Well, cucumbers are great, well, are warm weather loving vegetables, but they do like a little bit of shade in the hottest parts of the day, because they just kind of tend to kind of peter out a little bit. So you could protect them either in a shady spot where you just get afternoon shade, or what I've been doing actually here on my small space balcony, because it gets super hot here, is I've been covering them with some shade cloth. This is, I think it's a 40% block. So it'll block out 40% of the sun's rays. And what I do is I just put, well, I've got some stakes and trellises in here I can hang it over. I just kind of hang it over the garden bed. It doesn't have to be anything fancy. You can stick a stake in the corner. And then I usually just clip it on with one of these little clips. I think I bought this at Harbor Freight. You can also get them on Amazon. One little thing also that you can buy even at the office supply store is these little binder clips that will work just as well too. And a little note about that, make sure that your vegetables, Dolly actually mentioned that in the chat, before the live stream started. When you're hardening off your vegetables, make sure you fully transition them by gradually exposing them to the sun for about a week before you plant them outside, and then you might just to protect them, because they're tender little seedlings and they can easily get sunburnt. Okay guys, so hopefully that will help your vegetables be successful so you can grow a lot more vegetables in your garden. Okay guys, we are gonna do a drawing for the second live stream, or the second giveaway winner. Remember, we're giving away this 5-gallon Smart Pots container. And by the way guys, I just wanna thank Smart Pots here. They're our partner for the Small Space Garden Series. They've supplied all of the containers here. They've really made it possible for us to do this series. And they also very graciously embroidered my logo on some of the containers for our giveaway. So thank you so much, Smart Pots. You can check them out at smartpots.com. And send the video by some of their products. Okay, guys, we are ready for our winner number two. So here we go. We're gonna generate our second winner. This is so much fun. It's always exciting to do the live streams here and to find out who our second winner is. Okay guys, you can see the comment or the people scrolling by there. Our second winner of a 5-gallon fabric Smart Pots container is Sheila Mulidi Girardi. Thank you so much, Sheila, for commenting, and congratulations. And her comment says, I really like the teepee trellis. It would work best for my small garden because it's organic. Also, thanks for all the upcycle ideas. Very creative and inspiring. The tomato cages also work great. I've heard of fish emulsion, but not about worm tea or worm castings. Need to try those on my plants. Sheila, congratulations. That is absolutely fabulous. I'm so excited for you to grow in your Smart Pots container. And the teepee trellis, which is right here behind me, guys, which I made out of a tree branch and an old bamboo stake, is so much fun. It just looks nice and natural in the garden, and it's a lot of fun. I've got some peas planted, or no, cucumbers actually. Can you guys see those back there? Some cucumbers planted, and they're gonna climb really nicely and fill out the trellis. Okay, now for her surprise prize, and I bet you guys can't guess what it is again, right? Her surprise prize comes from our Small Space Garden Collection, seed collection, and it is a pack of the dwarf Taylor beans. I love these beans. They're absolutely gorgeous. They're a cream colored bean with little red speckles, and I've got some planted right here behind me. Can you guys see those right back there? They're a really nice compact plant, perfect for containers. They're in my Small Space Garden seed collection. Sheila, congratulations. I cannot wait for you to grow your new beans. It will go very nicely in this 5-gallon Smart Pots, and this is a really fun variety. I think you're gonna love it. Okay guys, so let me head back into the chat, get some questions going here. Congratulations. Oh, here's a great question from Patricia. How much room should I give my zucchini plants to grow? Very good question. I hope to do a video on growing zucchini my legs are getting all cramped up here, after we're done with the Small Space series, but I do have one you can go and check out on my channel. They really need about 2 to 3 feet. They're large plants. They like to bush out, and just want to give them a lot of space so that they can grow a lot of zucchini for you. So they are absolutely delicious. One of my favorite things to make out of zucchini is zucchini noodles. So I hope you guys have tried those. They beat pasta any day. Okay, one more question here from Kathia. Her question is, how do I know if I am growing determinate or indeterminate tomato plants? Great question, Kathia. And usually you can check, a lot of times they will say that on the seed packet. Not always though. So you probably will want to do a little bit of research on your own if the seed packet doesn't say that. I'm trying to think, oh yeah, the Tiny Tim that I have in here is a determinate tomato plant. And in case you're not familiar with that, determinate simply means that the plant will produce your crop or your harvest all at once or over a few weeks period of time, and then your plant will die. So with determinate plants, you can succession plants, you can get harvests kind of spread out during the season. Now an indeterminate tomato, which actually I have one right here. I think this is a beefsteak tomato plant, perhaps. Will produce a harvest over a long period of time, and then will die when it frosts. So that's the difference. And do your research if it doesn't say on the back of the pack. Okay, guys, we're gonna head back over and share one more tip about growing vertically before we do another winner. Okay, tip number two, why you should grow vertically is you will be able to have healthier plants that way. For example, a cucumber plant, it's a vining plant, and they like to vine and spread all over the ground. If you let them grow on the ground, they're more susceptible to diseases, to just to bugs, that type of thing, and they're not going to produce as well for you. So grow vertically, help them produce more, help them be healthier, and I think it just looks really pretty too. So a lot more production if you grow vertically. So first tip is that, what's my first tip? Oh yes, you'll be able to grow more vegetables. Second tip is you're going to have healthier plants that will also produce more for you, be able to grow more food in a little bit of space, which is our goal, right? Okay, guys, time for our third winner. Actually, we're going to pick our third and fourth winner here and head back over to our random comment picker. And let's see who the lucky winner is. So this is so much fun. There were so many wonderful comments. And you guys are just really getting creative with what you're doing for trellising. So I'm super glad to hear that. And our winner number three is the Domestic Handmaiden of Distinction. Congratulations. I cannot wait for you to grow in your new 5-gallon smart pots. Thanks for leaving your comment. Let me just read what her comment says, or his or her comment says. I always learn so much from your videos. Where do I begin? For the sake of the video contest, I certainly learned something that if I don't know about peas and cucumbers. I've been trying to grow various peas and cucumbers since last year. Although they started out well, for some reason they would just die on me. Then today I learned that peas prefer temperatures under 75 degrees and they need protection from the heat. The cucumbers, on the other hand, prefer 4 to 6 hours of sun and are warm weather veggies that like temperatures from 60 to 85 degrees in afternoon shade when the weather is hot. I'm planning new starts this week and I'm looking forward to greater success armed with better info. Okay, wonderful. Congratulations. And I am so glad that you learned about that, because with those very simple tips on just where to plant and what type of weather peas versus cucumbers like, you can definitely have a successful crop of each of those in your garden. So congratulations. And your surprise gift is a pack of the beefsteak tomato seeds. So the beefsteak tomato seeds are in my tomato seed collection on my website. Congratulations. I cannot wait for you to grow these guys. These are a wonderful, nice, large tomato plant. Here's my tomato collection. And if you guys didn't catch the video last week on the beefsteak challenge, Gary over at the Rustic Garden Gary has challenged me to grow a beefsteak tomato. Actually, I think this one is a beefsteak seedling, but it's not the one I'm growing for the challenge. And we're gonna see who can grow the biggest beefsteak tomato between now and August 1st. So make sure you go back and check that video and tune in to the beefsteak tomato challenge. Hopefully you'll grow along with us. So congratulations, and we're gonna choose another winner here. And then we'll go into the chat for some questions. Okay, this is winner. Next winner is winner number 4. So ding, 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 ding. Drum roll, please. This is so much fun. I hope you guys are having as much fun as I am here today. Okay, you can see all those names scrolling by. And our 4th winner is Christine Harrington. Congratulations, Christine, on winning the 5-gallon smart pots. And your comment says, I learned to use worm tea weekly, helps with plant nutrition. Hope I win. Well, you did win, Christine, so congratulations. Great job entering the contest. And you are absolutely right. The worm tea is a fabulous way to fertilize your plants. Containers need weekly fertilizing because the nutrients do tend to drain out a lot easier, and you want to keep them producing a lot of veggies for you. So the Vermistera worm tea is my favorite. It's wonderful, fabulous. I've used it in my garden for a couple of years now. Love the results. So if you want to use that too in your containers or anywhere in your garden, you can pick some up at vermistera.com. And make sure you use the promo code or the code CALIKIM. You can get a 10% discount. So let's see, her secret prize is a pack of the red romaine seeds. And this is a gorgeous, gorgeous, gorgeous red romaine lettuce. And it's in my lettuce seed collection. So congratulations. I can't wait for you to get some of these planted in your garden. And you're gonna love growing red romaine. It's so, so pretty. And a little note here about romaine lettuce. I just saw a question scroll by about how you can extend the growing season here in California for lettuce, because lettuce likes cool weather. Once it gets hot, it's really hard to grow. Grow romaine lettuce, heat tolerant variety, and it will definitely help extend the lettuce season. And also, again, use shade cloth. You can plant lettuce not only in a spot where it gets shade, or you can cover it with shade cloth to help extend the life of your lettuce. So give that a try, guys, and hopefully that'll help you grow lettuce in the heat. Okay, question here in the chat from Marianne. Hi, Marianne, good to see you on here. Is it okay if my raised bed gets rained on? We're gonna get around 2 inches of rain. Wow, lucky you, send some my way, would ya? absolutely, rain is fabulous for the garden. It has all kinds of wonderful minerals in it that are naturally occurring minerals. So I don't know if you guys have noticed this, but the minute I get a few sprinkles around here, my garden absolutely greens up. So I'd say if you're gonna get an absolute torrential rainfall, and 2 inches is a lot, but make sure, number one, of course, your raised beds, containers obviously need to have drainage. If it's gonna be super, super heavy rainfall, you may wanna throw a cover over it. Just make sure you give some good airflow, but there's not much we can do about Mother Nature. So we just go with it and make the best of it that we can. Okay, one more question in the chat and then we'll head back over and do another tip. Stephanie, hi, how are you today? How do you water the saddlebags? Okay, great question, Stephanie. And let me see if I have, I've got one right behind me. It's not planted yet. Actually have some, you can see right over there that are all planted out. And those you can hook up drip irrigation to them. I don't prefer to do that because I like to move them around. They're not attached to the wall, unless you want to attach them to your wall, but mine are not. And the reason why is because sometimes I might plant lettuce in them when it's cooler weather, and as the weather warms up, I'm gonna plant some warmer weather vegetables that'll take the heat. And I like the flexibility to be able to move them around to the sun or to the shade. So I'm just watering them with a watering can. So you just kind of have to stay on top of it. They're smaller containers, so they do need water, especially in the heat, probably every day. Okay guys, one more tip on why you should grow vertically. The last tip here that I'm gonna share today about vertical gardening is the third reason to grow vertically is to create kind of a privacy screen or to define your garden space. So you might have an ugly wall that you want to hide. For example, right over here, we've got like all of our trash cans and some stuff that might not look so pretty. We have our air conditioner unit here. So maybe you want a little bit of privacy from your neighbors, or you want to hide an ugly space. It really helps once the plants fill in and grow up, you can create like a privacy barrier to hide ugly items in your fence or yard or what have you. So great reason to grow vertically. And you might want to choose something that's fast growing, like the cucumbers I have back here or the peas I have right over here. and that'll help your fill out your space and help things grow in quickly. So first tip, grow more food with a little bit of space. You can grow more vegetables. Second tip is you're gonna have healthier plants, which will produce more for you. Third tip, third reason why you should grow vertically is because you can create a privacy screen or a barrier from something ugly that you don't want people to see. Okay, a couple more questions, guys, and then we'll go over and finish up our giveaway drawing. This is so much fun. Okay, Pretty Alice Moon. Hi, how are you? Welcome. How do you attract worms to your garden? I notice I have very few. Okay. One of my favorite ways to attract worms is by mulching with leaves. So if you can get your hands, Alice, on some shredded leaves, really any type of mulch will help attract the worms because it'll keep your soil more moist, but they really seem to love the leaves. It gives them some organic matter to feed on, and they just kind of munch it down. So the best thing that I found is to mulch with leaves over the winter time. That really brings in the worms. But now that we're coming into spring, if you can get leaves or if you can get even some straw, don't use hay because it has a lot of seeds in it, but if you can get yourself some straw or leaves, cover your garden beds with them, shred them up into as small pieces as you can, and mix compost into your soil. Any organic matter that you can put into your soil really, really helps bring in the worms. Okay, one more question here. And question from Teresa Creamer. Hello, Teresa. Why does my baby cucumber seedling have yellowing on the bottom leaves? Okay, that possibly could be the first little leaves that break the soil are called the little baby leaves. There is a technical term for them. I'm not gonna bore you with that, but they're called the baby leaves. And usually as the cucumber seedling continues to grow, those little baby leaves will yellow and fall off. So no big deal, don't get worried about it. You can even just pinch them off. And then your other leaves are gonna just grow beautifully and your seedling will continue to grow. So not to worry about that. Okay, this is gonna be our giveaway winner number 5. Over here in the chat, or over here on my YouTube random comment picker. So let's go ahead and, oh, and by the way, I forgot to mention, this is our grand prize winner. Okay, guys, our grand prize winner. And here we go, filtering through. Are you guys ready for this? Grand prize winner. And how come it's not working? It did this to me last time too. I'm gonna go ahead and re-enter the URL. Oops. Be patient with me, guys, while you wait for the grand prize winner here. This is exciting. And don't quit on me now, YouTube random comment picker. Hopefully it'll keep going. You guys waiting here. Cross your fingers, good luck. Here we go. We are in business here. And our grand prize winner of a 5-gallon Smart Pots is Joe. Hi, Joe, how are you? I hope you're on here. Joe comments on almost all of my videos. He's been a viewer for a long, long time. I'm so happy that he won. Congratulations. His comment is, cattle panels are a staple in my garden, as well as 1/2-inch metal electrical conduit and bamboo poles. But I never thought about old garden tools. I have a few and they will now find a new job in my garden as decorative trellises. Thanks for the great tip. Joe, that is awesome. I love the electrical conduit idea and the garden tools idea. It adds a lot of fun to your garden. So Joe, are you ready? Here's what you won. You, the grand, besides the 5-gallon Smart Pots, the grand prize is, here we go, Joe, you won a full-on small space garden seed collection. The full collection, there's 10 seeds in here, some wonderful compact vegetables for you to grow, like the little dwarf Taylor bean here. And it also has the, let me see if I have one. Yes, I do. The little Marvel pea. Nice compact plants that will grow you a lot of vegetables in your garden. And hopefully you can get some of those really wonderful old garden tool trellises and climb some of these veggies up your trellises. So Joe, congratulations. I am so happy that you won. And I look forward to sending out your prize to you. So guys, if you were one of the 5 winners, please send me your contact information to CALIKIM@CALIKIMGardenAndHome.com. Send it to me by this Friday, which I believe is the 27th. So if you can email me your information, we'll get the prizes shipped out to you. Thank you guys so, so much for all of your wonderful participation. And before I forget, we're gonna draw three runners up just in case for some reason I don't hear from people, or if one of our winners is out of the country. So our third, our three runners up are, first runner up is, ding, 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 Diane Bortz. Thank you, Diane, for entering. Her comment is, great video. I love them so much. I learned something with every video. So exciting. Thank you for letting us into your gardens. Diane, that's a wonderful comment. Thank you so much. That warms my heart. And congratulations on being one of the first runner-up. So if someone doesn't reply and send me their contact information, you'll be the first one to get the prize. Second runner-up here, guys. And thank you guys so much for taking time out of your day to join me here. I really appreciate it. It's so much fun to hang out with you. Second runner-up is VM Perkins. VM, congratulations on being the second runner-up. Your comment says, I love the idea of using old tree branches as trellises. I would have never thought of using them. I received my smart pots and worm castings and tea in a week. I've seen a big difference in my small space garden. This has been my most successful small space gardening experience. Thanks for all the gardening tips. Yes, that Vermistera worm tea absolutely does the trick. It is wonderful and will really help your garden be healthy and productive and grow you a lot of vegetables. So our third runner up for the 5-gallon smart pots, Angie Conley, third runner up, congratulations. I learned that you can trellis peas and cucumbers, which I didn't know before. Dad never did so. I didn't think you could. I'll be integrating trellises into my raised garden beds. I have plants under a grow light, but I still can't plant outside yet. It's still too cold. I hope to win a smart pot on Monday because Monday is my birthday. Angie, happy birthday. That's awesome. Well, if someone doesn't contact me, you will be the third runner up to get a smart pot. So guys, thank you so much. I really appreciate all the participation. And right now I want to head back into the chat real quick, do a few last questions before we sign off. Congratulations. Stephanie, thank you for joining us on your lunch hour. I really appreciate it. Let's see here if we have any more questions. A lot of people are saying congratulations. So, oh, Kaden, Jessica, your son said maybe next time. We will, guys, we will have another live stream or another giveaway drawing on the Small Space Garden series. So make sure you stay tuned for that. It's awesome, guys. I don't see any more questions, but if you guys have some more, go ahead and pop them in. We have time for a couple more. And while I do that, just a couple of little comments here. Make sure, guys, I get a lot of questions about where to get things, like the trellises that I have back here, some of the supplies that I use in my videos. Always, guys, make sure you check the video description. There's a wealth of information there, a lot of links there, and you can also help support this channel by ordering through my Amazon links or by ordering my seeds over my website, CALIKIMGardenAndHome.com. It's been a lot of fun to ship out seeds to a lot of you and see a lot of you guys receiving them and able to plant your gardens very affordably with the seed collections. So, oh, here's some questions. Temperatures range from 40 to 60 from Gardening and Gaming Goober. Can I plant lettuce outdoors yet? Absolutely. Lettuce you can plant outdoors. That's the perfect temperature for lettuce. You can even get lettuce planted outdoors when it's still frosting outside. So if you can get some transplants started, or if you can't, go ahead and get some seeds started. But you can grow lettuce for transplants inside under grow lights, and they'll be ready in about 2 weeks to get them outdoors. So get them planted. This weekend, we're gonna be planting, on our video this weekend, we're gonna be planting some lettuce in these vertical crates here and in these stack towers and the walls there. So there's all kinds of ways you can grow vertically. And lettuce is a great, super easy crop to start with. Okay, let me see if there's a few more questions in the chat here. Maybe one or two more before we sign off. Jocelyn, hi, how are you, Jocelyn? What should I use to control aphids in the garden, neem oil or live ladybugs? Well, it's good to use both. I've done ladybugs before. However, in case you guys didn't know, ladybugs eat aphids. I have a hard time though sometimes keeping the ladybugs to stick around. So neem oil is always a great option. You can check out neem oil over at therustedgarden.com. Gary has neem oil for sale over there, and I've got videos on how to use that in your garden too that you can check out. But you want to make sure that you spray it on a regular basis to get rid of those aphids. The first line of defense though, just spray your plants with water, and it'll spray the aphids off and get them going. Okay, here's a question from Sariti Business. Can I buy your tomatoes, strawberry, and bell pepper seeds from my country? Tomatoes and bell peppers, yes. I don't sell strawberry seeds, but I do have a tomato and a pepper collection. And they are, here's my pepper collection. I don't think I showed that. But anyway, they're available at my website, and I do ship to the USA, the UK, to Australia, Canada, and India. So if you're in one of those countries, you can definitely order my seed collections and get yourself some of the seeds going. And the fun thing is, guys, I'm really having fun with these because I'm growing these vegetables. A lot of you guys now who have purchased my seeds are growing the vegetables too. So we're growing the same vegetables together. We can compare notes over on Instagram or Facebook or here in the YouTube comments. And it's just been a lot of fun to see how things grow in different parts of the country. Okay guys, one more question here. And can I fertilize my tomato plant once it starts producing fruit? From Carla. Hi Carla. Absolutely. You want to keep those tomatoes, feed them on a regular basis throughout the growing season. Containers, you would fertilize once a week. Your in-ground plants, you can fertilize every 2 to 3 weeks, or even once a month is fine. And I always use the worm tea and the worm castings to fertilize my plant. You can just water things in with worm tea, spread a little bit of worm castings along the top of the soil, and water it in with worm tea, and your tomatoes are going to be absolutely fabulous. Okay guys, we are out of time for today. Sorry we went a little bit long, but it's been so much fun. And make sure you join us on the weekend video as we talk about more ways we can vertical garden. And also join me on the midweek video. I'm not going to tell you what that is. It's going to be a surprise. You have to show up to my channel on Wednesday and check out Wednesday's video. Thank you guys so much for taking time out of your day to join me here in the garden and for growing your vegetables. Great job. All right, guys, we'll see you later. Bye-bye.